اوسيفيكيشن سنتر نيمونيك كريت وي باي ذا ايج اوف 1 يير كابيتيلا 3 يير راديال هيد 5 يير انترنال ابيكوندايل ات مين ميديال ابيكوندايل. ال 7 هو التروكيليا وال 9 يير هو الاولكرانو وال 11 هو الاكسترنال ابيكوندايل. This video it will show us the how we interpret elbow radiograph with ossification center, and we have any fracture of dislocation. How we interpret and approach the X-ray.
الحافز الصوت موجود.
معك في
لا
الصوت
ده دكتورة هي بس يعني
هو بس تأشير.
بس تأشير والكتابة موجودة عليها. If you need, Doctor, I will explain. In this video, it explained that we have to know the age of the young child and the ossification center. The ossification center is very important to know that the age of the child. For example, if you have a medial epicondyle fracture, مثلا, وما شفنا الاوسيفيكيشن, يعني إلبو فراكتشر وما شفنا الميديال إبيكوندال وشفنا التريكوي, معناتها هذا الإيج of development of the tracheal internal epicondyle develop before the trochlea. ف تصير يعني you have to not miss, you don't say this is an ossification center still not develop. You have to look for the intra joint fragment of the medial epicondyle. And here it يعني explain that if you have مثلا five year child and come to you with the five year will come to you مثلا you see any finding at the olecranon or external epicondyle, you have to يعني to don't mess with the ossification center because the child 5 year it olecranon and external epicondyle not develop in this age group and you regard it as this is a fracture. Radiological imaging of the elbow and forearm, we have plain radiograph demonstrate osseous anatomy and provide some osseous anatomy than plain, sorry, demonstrate osseous anatomy and provide some detail of the soft tissue anatomy. Fluoroscopy allow real-time dynamic radiographic assessment of the osseous anatomy and assessment of the joint using fluoroscopic arthrography. Nowadays, this option is not this imaging is not used because we have MR arthrography. Sonography allow high spatial resolution and dynamic imaging of the soft tissue, not obscured by osseous structure. It is particularly optimal for visualization of small and superficial structure like ligament, tendon, as well as muscle compartment. Doppler ultrasound for forearm vessels uses ultrasound to look at the blood flow in the large artery and vein in the forearm. We have cross-sectional imaging of the L1 forearm. CT, multi-slice CT provide more information about the osseous anatomy than plain radiograph showing the trabecular anatomy of the bone in much higher detail. High resolution 3D reconstruction of the upper limb allow in interrogation in any desired plane. Soft tissue, including muscle, tendon, and joint, can also be identified, but these are best assessed with ultrasound and MR imaging. MRI imaging offer high contrast resolution imaging of the musculoskeletal anatomy. Intraarticular structure are best assessed using MRI arthrography. These are X-ray of elbow joint AP view. We have coronoid olecranon fossa here. We have olecranon. We have lateral epicondyle of the humerus. We have medial epicondyle. This is the trochlea. This is the coronoid process. This is the capital limb. This is the radial head, radial neck, and radial tuberosity. This is the radius. This is the ulna. X-ray of the elbow joint lateral view. We have this is humerus, this is the coronoid fossa, this is the olecranon fossa, this is the capitulum, this is the trochlea, and this is the olecranon of the ulna. This is the anterior third part, this is the coronoid process, radial head, radial neck, radial tuberosity, radius, and ulna. We have X-ray of the elbow joint oblique view. Medial oblique view, this in this position, they take it and we see olecranon fossa, trochlea, coronoid, capitulum, radial head. Lateral oblique view in this way, medial epicondyle, olecranon fossa, capitulum, olecranon, coronoid, tubercle, radial head, ulna, radial notch of the ulna. When we have an elbow, we have to look for two lines. The first one is the radiocapitular line. This line drawn at the neck of the radius and intersect the capitulum. This is in front view and this is in lateral view. Clinical aspect, when we see this line not intersect the capitulum, it means we have radial head dislocation. This is a frontal view, this is a lateral view. We see the line not intersect the capitulum of the humerus. We have an anterior humeral line, a line drawn along the anterior cortex of the humerus shaft, seen passing the middle third of the capitulum. In supracondylar fracture, we see here the less than one third of the capitulum is in front of this line, and we have a raised anterior and posterior third pad due to effusion, and we see the fracture line. Even we don't see the fracture line, if we see this sign, it means this is a supracondylar fracture, and this fracture is very common in children. We have the lateral view of the forearm. We have here carpal bone is not our subject, but these are the carpal bone, the ulna head, the ulna, the radius, the radial neck, the radial head, the olecranon process, the humerus. We have frontal view of the forearm. These are carpal bone. This is the styloid process of the radius. This is the radius. This is the radial tubercle, radial neck, radial head. And this one is the styloid process of the ulna, ulnar head, ulna, trochlea, and olecranon process. We have humerus, capitulum of humerus, and the trochlea of the humerus superimposed by the olecranon process. We have MRI of the ligament of the elbow. Here we have external common extensor tendon, and we have lateral collateral ligament. Here we have the lateral ulnar collateral ligament. Here we have annular ligament. We have an MRI of the elbow and forearm sagittal view. As we said, the biceps, brachii and triceps are not our subject, but are present here. This is the bicep, and this is the brachialis muscle. This is the capitella. This is the radial nerve. This is the brachioradialis muscle. This is the pronator teres muscle. Here we have triceps muscle. We have a shaft of the humerus. We have ulcronum fossa. We have ulcronum. Here we have trochlear notch, supinator muscle, and extensor digitorum profundum muscle. MRI of the elbow joint and forearm coronal view, humerus, ulcronum fossa, medial epicondyle, radial head, common extensor tendon, supinator muscle, extensor digitorum muscle, extensor carpi radialis longus muscle, ulnar nerve, triceps muscle, medial head of it, humerus medial epicondyle, common flexor tendon, palmaris longus tendon, medial collateral ligament, ulna, flexor digitorum profunda muscle, flexor digitorum profunda muscle. عفوا flexor digitorum superficial muscle, flexor digitorum profundus muscle. We have axial view of the elbow. We have ulcronum of the ulna. Here we have medial side. Here we have lateral side. We see the ulnar nerve posterior to the medial epicondyle. This is the medial epicondyle. This is the common flexor tendon. This is the pronator teres, brachialis tendon, trochlea, biceps brachii tendon, brachioradialis muscle, capitella, common extensor tendon, lateral epicondyle, and corneas, extensor carpi radialis longus. We have axial MRI of the right forearm. Here we have a diagram. This is the radius ulna, in between the interosseous membrane, anterior compartment, posterior compartment muscle, this one deep fascia, and this is the skin. Here we have the radius ulna, interosseous membrane, anterior compartment, posterior compartment, and these are the intermuscular septa. We have the CT scan of the elbow joint. Here we have ulcronum process of the ulna, medial epicondyle of the ulna, basilic vein, pronator teres muscle, brachialis muscle, brachial artery, ulcronon fossa of the humerus, cephalic vein, brachioradialis muscle, extensor carpi radialis longus muscle, lateral epicondyle, and corneus muscle. Here we have a transverse ultrasound of cubital tunnel. This is an ulcronon process of the ulna and the medial epicondyle. The tunnel is composed of the floor and roof. The roof is the floor is a group between the ulcronum of the ulna and the medial epicondyle, and the roof is formed by the ligament of Osborne, which connected the humeral head and the humeral head and ulnar head of the flexor carpi ulnaris. This is the ulnar nerve. This is the proximal part of this tunnel, and this is the distal part of this tunnel. The same thing. This is the ulna, ulcronal process of the ulna. This is the medial epicondyle. This is the roof, floor of the tunnel. And this is the roof of the tunnel formed by a ligament connecting the ulnar head and humeral head of the flexor carpi ulnaris. This is the ulnar nerve. We have Doppler ultrasound of the forearm bosses. The distal brachial artery can be followed to just below the elbow. Here we see the side of it. Below about 1 cm below the elbow, the brachial artery divided in two. The radial artery laterally and the medial, the ulnar artery medially, and the tubular waveform are triphysics, all of them. Any question?
أكو أحد عنده سؤال؟ ماكو سؤال، تفضلي دكتور.
Thank you for listening. We have a quiz after that. If there is no
أوكي.
any question.
عاشت يدك، يلا إذا هاي حتى نروح على الكويز. تفضلي.
This is the
حيدر،
quiz.
اوكي
نعم أستاذ.
تفضل.
The annular ligament of the elbow blend with the ulnar collateral ligament. This statement is false with the radial.
بالضبط. دكتورة رحيمة.
نعم. The bicipital aponeurosis separates the superficial median cubital vein from the deeper brachial artery. True.
سيزيترو. محمد إبراهيم.
نعم أستاذ. The ulna articulates with the carpal bones. False. No articulation.
صحيح. شكو بيناتين؟
أستاذ الترايانجولار فايبرو كارتيج كومبلكس.
اكسلنت. عاشتي. عايشة عبد الحميد نمبر فور.
نعم أستاذ. The distal radio ulnar joint has no communication with the carpal joint. True.
صحيح. وسؤالين كملت هذاك. تفضل أستاذ محمد.
شكرا أستاذ رعد. شكرا. نعم أستاذ رعد وياكم. هاوري نمبر 1.
نعم أستاذ. راديال كيبروس.
راديال كيبروس. نور فان نمبر 2. نور مينا مازن نمبر 2.
دكتور اولكرانون فوسي.
نعم نور. نور ويانا.
اي نعم دكتور.
وعليكم السلام. مينا مازن ثلاثة.
نعم دكتور. ثلاثة lateral epicondyle uplift humerus.
صفا عباس نمبر 4.
نعم أستاذ. النمبر 4 capitulum of left humerus.
وآخر شيء سورين نمبر 5.
نعم أستاذ. هاي ال coronary process of left ulna.
عشت ايدك دكتورة هيفاء. كمل مو؟
بلي أستاذ.
شكرا جزيلا. عشت ايدك حقيقة، يعني غطيتي للموضوع تغطية كاملة، والراديولوجيكال ايمجين كلية